Now we are going to talk about how to use a transistor and switch. An electric switch is used to allow or delay the passage of current. And a transistor is an electrically driven switch. In a bijunction transistor, the collector current is limited by its base current, and hence a bijunction transistor can be used as a current control switch. In order to know how to use a bijunction transistor as a switch, let us consider a very simple electric circuit. Now in this circuit, the switch was in open state. So there will not be any current in the circuit and LED will not glow. So in order to drive the LED on, I have to bring the switch to closed state. So in order to bring the switch to closed state, I have to provide some mechanical movement to the switch. So let us replace the switch with the NPN transistor. Now in this circuit, I replace the mechanical switch with a transistor. So if there is no base current through this transistor, transistor will be in cutoff region and behaves as an open switch, and there will not be any current in the circuit. If the base current through the transistor is large enough to drive the transistor to saturation region, then the transistor behaves as a closed switch and current conducts through the circuit and LED glows. The base current required to drive the transistor to saturation region could be very small compared to actual current through the circuit. That means, consider a very small amount of current produced due to a small amount of electricity produced by a sensor. Say it was a solar cell. Consider it was a solar cell and produces very small amount of electricity when sunlight falls on it. So whenever the light falls, the solar cell produces very small amount of electricity, and due to the electricity, there will be some very small amount of base current. This current is not large enough to drive the LED, but it was large enough to drive the transistor to saturation. So it conducts electricity and LED glows with the power supplied by an actual voltage source that we provide earlier. And this is how we can use an electrical signal instead of a mechanical movement to drive the switch on or off.